give away all their money just to watch someone flip paper squares on a table.
Welcome back to Honest Hearts. We had to go and dump some loot at one of those duffel bags, and now we're gonna convince Follows Chug not to go to the big city. Got it better here, honestly.
Welcome back. What can I do for you? I thought he might. It's been some time since I've visited civilized places. I don't have fond memories of them. But I have always seen these places from the outside. I'd rather not influence him more than I already do. Why don't you talk to him? Whatever you tell him, I'm sure it will be fine. It's still his choice to make. I just want him to make it without looking to me for approval. He's a man. He can make his own decisions.
Oh, he hasn't restocked yet. I think he'd get murdered his first week, like out in the, quote, civilized world.
What can I tell you?
Yeah? What did he say? He said that? Well, I guess you have been out there more recently than he has. So, what's your advice? I see. Well, thanks for your telling. I'd like a minute alone to think about this. Thank me.
Have that at 95. gonna go with this because I'm tired of those 30% in vats. Okay, we're gonna go get this last item now.
Ready, steady, fighting. This one looks pretty tough. Bad guys dealt with.
You know the quest, there's two quests that end this. The one that to evacuate doesn't make a whole lot of sense. We'll be back there later.
Time to fight. Fighting over. Do you like me? Time to fight.
Guess I'm just jumping.
Cessation of hostilities complete.
They jangle like crazy.
Sneaking done. Fighting now. Cessation of hostilities complete. This one looks pretty tough.
No,
bad guys dealt with.
I'm gonna have to go to these other locations for a quest with the new follower I pick up. No use.
Time to fight.
I'm getting some deceptive intel.
That's all.
So I finally get to explore all those taboo places without the other scouts yelling at me? Can't wait.
The Randall Clark's disciples.
That's the Sorrow's territory. They're peaceful enough, but you don't want to make them mad. The shadow of a ghost.
In here, I'm a waste of time.
There can't really be a place.
Yeah, the people stuck in the walls. Very fast, probably. Get her out of there.
What can I tell you? Sure. You are... Well then, let's get to trading.
Nope, stuck in the...
You are the one Joshua Graham sent to us. Blessings of the Father in the cave on you. Daniel is waiting for you. Have you not heard of the God of the new Canaanites? He is our protector and our judge. He helped our ancestors find their place here in Zion. He gave us many gifts, but we are not to seek him out. His caves are forbidden to us. Those who seek them out are taken from us. Perhaps you do not fully understand the new Canaanites. I have seen the Father's images. His holy bride and holy son were given unto the world to save it. They dwelt in the caverns of the mountains, caverns which can still be seen today. The people sinned against him and were punished with the end that came in fire and the loss of the holy tongue. Only the new Canaanites were spared. I'm sure Daniel could tell you more. His knowledge of the Father is greater than my own.
Daniel isn't very good missionary if he can't see that they're talking about something completely different.
Asaro's Yaogwai fist is a sacred symbol. It shows that we belong to the tribe and have willingly undertaken a dangerous quest to aid the tribe. Each sorrow makes his own, and only after hunting and slaying a Yaogwai that threatened our people. Our shaman, White Bird, oversees the rites. Perhaps if you spoke to him, he would allow you to undertake such a quest. Daniel is a wise man and a great friend to the sorrows. He taught me to speak the language of New Canaan, the English, from the holy books. Yes, the language of the new Canaanites is the holy tongue, for it is the language their sacred books are written in. The father in the caves brought it to them after the judgment, but the ancestors of the sorrows sinned against him. They were denied the true tongue. 6 years, he attended the birth of my third child. It was a hard birth. The river nearly carried my water to the father, and my child's with it. Daniel knew the ways of New Canaan's medicine. He stepped in and saved both of our lives. After the birth, I asked Daniel if he would teach me what he knew of childbirth. He agreed, and so here I am.
Can Daniel help you get out of that rock?
What would you speak of? We have dwelt in the Narrows since the end that came in fire, when the Father in the caves punished the world and made us forget the Holy Tongue. We have had good relations with the other tribes in the valley, at least before Salt Upon Wounds brought his white legs here. We have Daniel to thank for our continued existence. His advice and help has kept the white legs from overrunning us so far. I do not know how long even he can protect us, though. He is war chief of the White Legs, and the worst butcher of them all. The tribes he has crushed are many, the warriors he has slain, doubtless. Waking Cloud is my name. I am midwife to the Sorrows. It sounds ill omen, no? Midwife to Sorrows? The children and the old have already been evacuated from the camp. They are safe enough, unless the White Legs come for us in force. I tend to other hurts and sicknesses that afflict our tribe. I also scout the valley for the herbs I use in my medicines.
The dead horse has told me details about the attack on your caravan. A stranger's sympathy might not count for much, but for what it's worth, I'm sorry. The sorrows will mourn your friends too. They mourn everyone, even the White Legs. They have sensitive souls, innocent if there is such a thing. In spite of what's happened, I hope that Joshua and I can help you out of here. But to be frank, we need your help too. There's an old saying that goes, if you want peace, get ready for war. You've got me figured half right. I'll shoot dead any White Leg that tries to creep into this camp. But it's only to protect the Sorrows. The Lord helps those who help themselves. But the Sorrows don't know how. Joshua and I do. Since I got them into this mess, I need to get them out. There is an important difference between killing in defense and waging war. Even a Gentile like you should know that.
Gentile, huh? Strike one.
Joshua is a living Bible of all mankind's miseries of war. The debt he has levied through his actions, he repays every day. He is a monument both to God's unending forgiveness and to humanity's unfathomable capacity for cruelty. It's written on every inch of his body. When you look at him, do you only see a man of God? Beneath those bandages, he is burned flesh. As he burns, so does he consume everyone around him. Joshua wants to fight because the White Legs have stoked the naked flame inside of him. You see the light, but do not yet feel the heat. I can pray that you never will. But it isn't up to me, and it isn't up to God. It's up to Joshua. They're hateful savages who live only to plunder and destroy. Their leader is a devil called Salt Upon Wounds. War is all he knows. Everything he has, everything that tribe has, was taken by force, raiding, and scavenging. It's said there's no man deadlier at close range, that power fist of his has smashed 100 skulls. Maybe that's true, but so what? It's a low form of leadership. A tribe that knows only war has no future. And so he'll lead them to Caesar. I used to help the Sorrows with various medical problems and general issues they were having, but my bishop sent me here as a missionary. We new Canaanites believe that there is a path to salvation for everyone, and it's important that we set people on that path if they are willing. Yeah. Bishop Mordecai is... Sorry. Mordecai was my bishop. He was killed by White Legs during the attack on New Canaan. He was responsible for our congregation there. I don't know who my next bishop will be, but that's a problem for tomorrow. There are plenty of troubles here for us today. We lost it. Our community, everything. But the past is gone. We have to look forward. True enough. We can't escape it no matter how hard we try. Best we can do is own up. Trust in the Lord to forgive. Joshua was gone. So were a lot of the other new Canaanites. White Legs must have been watching for a long while, counting who remained. We didn't think the White Legs were a real threat. Maybe it was overconfidence. Maybe sloth. Either way, we didn't see them coming. They attacked at night. They killed without regard to age or infirmity. Armed or unarmed, they beat children to... beat them to death in their beds while they were sleeping. And now we're all that's left. Maybe 30 of us.
He wants to let them go.
Pride goeth before destruction.
Gotta agree with Joshua on this.
I'd like you to drop it. I never thought I'd be in charge of anything. Don't know why. Bishop Mordecai was old, He had been sick for years. He couldn't walk anymore. It wasn't a problem for the rest of us. He made it out to be more trouble than it really was. Just his way, I guess. When the White Legs came, he was upstairs. We couldn't get him out in time. The house caught fire at the base and worked its way up. Fast. He didn't die of smoke. I wish he had. Sometimes I wake up and for a minute or two, I think all of it was a dream. But it's not. It wasn't. I wish all of this were some fevered vision of what could have been, instead of what is, what we let happen.
Do you think they would have dared attack if Joshua was there? I don't think they would have.
Father in the... Oh, right. He's some spirit the Sorrows used to believe in. Watched over them from the caves in the valley. They marked some of the caves around here because they think they'll be punished for going inside. I think as more of them learn the teachings of the new Canaanites, they'll lose their old superstitions. Oh? Oh. Of course. How stupid of me. They probably also think Mary is the mother and Jesus is the child. No wonder they picked up on things so easily. I guess it just goes to show how difficult it is to communicate sometimes. Well, I'll be. I was starting to lose hope we'd be able to get any of this, much less all of it. Tribals are smart, but, well, they're ignorant. Letting go of a taboo is difficult for them. So I knew it would have to be one of us. Turns out all it took was a Gentile, or, no offense. These supplies are a godsend. But if we're going to evacuate Zion without drawing more White Leg attention, I need you to go back into the valley. Specifically, I need you to scout out some locations for White Legs and try to recover a map of Grand Staircase, a wilderness area to the east. There's also the matter of the roads. We're going to be heading out of the east side of the park, but I'm not sure the way is clear.
You're not going to be heading out the east side of the park. You're going to be staying here.
I appreciate the enthusiasm. There aren't a lot of people in the wasteland with kindness to spare for anyone who isn't kin. Since you've been poking around the valley, you might see more activity from the White Legs. One of the Sorrow's hunters, Waking Cloud, has volunteered to help guide you through the valley. She has a special talent for staying out of sight. After this, it's just a matter of getting everyone out of here safe and sound. And hopefully, you can head back to the Mojave without any more trouble.
Well, here we part ways. I'm needed back at the Dead Horse's camp. Maybe I'll see you there sometime. I will. Good gunnen, Akis.
River monsters. Yeah. I think the only way to run out of those. And then you had to go to the ocean.
Daniel said that I was to travel with you until you have completed your scouting. Is this pleasing to you? Certainly. We should make haste then.
space for this. My, speedrun coming down. I'm just interested in the last survivalist game. Quest done, where we gotta kill a Yaogwai whilst high off our ass.
Father.
Hola, outsider. Welcome, child of omens. You come to receive visions of truth? Take drugs, kill a bear, seek medicine plant, return with sacred Datura root. Receive visions of truth, they guide you. Go. Return, maybe yes. Return, maybe no. But go.
I ask that you guide this woman, who is the vessel of your will. Show her the light of your wisdom and the peace of your love. Amen.
Gonna like it when I come into his last cave. His last journal entries. Mines in here.
We pass, O Father. Guide and protect us, your humble children, as we labor in the vineyards, and make us strong to resist those who would steal Zion from us.
Some Vault 22 scum right here.
Thank you.
see anything that was connected to those tripwires, though. I don't see a grenade bouquet here. Slayer.
Oh Father, guide and protect us, your humble children, as we labor in the vineyards, and make us strong to resist those who would steal Zion from us.
Vault 22 is more fucked than it looked like in there. And did it make him psychotic? Or infection or what? Because obviously some of them survived. He would have let that bullet let him bleed out if he didn't want to kill all these Vault 22 people. Yeah, that's the group that we just, March 2nd, that's the group that we just saw there. One final entry where his body is. and break my leg.